Hello everyone! Here are three ways to handle collisions for parallax maps in RPG Maker MV. We'll be looking at using a tileset, using Yanfly's regional restrictions, and QMovement's collision maps. So let's start with setting up our collisions with a regular tileset. Import one of the A5 tilesets into the image editor of your choice. Erase the image, set up a 48 grid, and now let's put in some tiles. Let's leave the first two blank. Let's make the third completely red. Afterwards, we have one for each of the four directions. Next up, one for the ladder. And afterwards, one for each possible four direction combination. For example, left and up, up and right, and something like up and down or left and right. And finally, let's add one for the bushes. We'll make that one green. And now let's lower the opacity a bit so we can see our parallax map below, and we are good to go. Now let's bring the tileset into the engine. Go to your database and down for tilesets. Name it something like collision or call or something, whatever you like. And under A5, import your tileset we just created, and everything else isn't needed. Now let's set up the passabilities. Set the red one to an X. Set the ladder to ladder, the green one to bushes, and for everything else, select for deer and set the corresponding directions to your graphics. And once that is done, we can close it, go to our map, right-click, go to the settings, select the tile set, and now we can paint in our collisions. And with that done, let's move on to the next one. Now let's set up Yanfly's regional restrictions. This one is part of a free starter set, which you can download on Quxios. I'll leave a link down in the description. So take the plugin, put it into your plugins folder, go in Engine, Plugin Manager, and load in the plugin. Here you can see a bunch of modes and set a region for each of these. Do so as you see fit. I just used regions 1 to 5 and let allow everything at 0, so I don't have to paint in something when I want everything to be able to walk there. Now we can select the region tab from the tileset tab and paint in our regions accordingly to what we set up. So restrict all would be 3 for me, so I take region ID 3 and paint in collisions everywhere I want them. The downside of region restrictions is that you don't have the fine tuning you have with tilesets, because you can either walk or can't walk on a tile. With tilesets you have the options of 4 directions. So you can walk onto a tile, but you can set up which directions you can or can't leave. In my example here, you can see that I had to block out the tiles left and right to the stairs. While with the tile set, I still could put the tiles there with 4 directions, which I just couldn't leave through the left or right. So I could still walk on that tile, just not up to the stairs, or down from the stairs. But region restrictions are very handy for one thing. You can decide who can walk onto that area. For example, you can choose restrict event or restrict player. As an example, if you have 3 roaming monsters, you can create a safe zone for your player, simply by just allowing the player. You can combine the tileset collision with Yanfly's region restrictions simply to get the best from both techniques. Let's move on to the third option, QMovement's collision map. This one comes in combination with QMovement, which is a pixel movement plugin, and you will also need QPlus. They are by a creator called Quxios, which I hope is somewhat correct, and I leave a link to their GitHub down in the description. You can download the plugins by hitting right-click on the raw button and selecting save. Now let's import all 3 plugins into RPG Maker MV. Remember, you need QPlus, QMovement, and QMovement collision map. What this allows you to do is create an image, like an image overlay for your map, and every pixel that isn't transparent is a collision. So you can take something like red and paint every area that isn't walkable anymore into red. So if you check out QMovement, this gives you the opportunity to set up a collider for your sprite. Let's imagine you painted a very small path onto one of your collision maps. If your collider is bigger than that, you still can't walk onto that path. So you always have to keep the width of your sprite, or better, the collision box in mind when you design overlays for your map. A big downside of this plugin is that the engine has to load an extra image file on top of all the parallax layers it's already loading and check pixel perfect collisions every time. So it constantly has to check your position against the pixels on that map, so that gets pretty daunting when you have big maps. So I only recommend this for smaller maps. Otherwise, you might end up with something like lag or imperfect collisions, and who wants that? So, to connect your map with the collision map, you have to put this command into your map's node box. The folder that will search for the image file you can set up from within the plugin. By standard setup, it uses the Parallaxes folder, but you can change that. And once you're in playtest mode, you can use F10 to toggle the collision overlay on and off. I think that's it for this plugin. So these are three ways to put collisions onto your Parallax maps. I hope this was helpful. If you have any questions, feel free to ask away in the comment section. A comment, like, or subscribe would be much appreciated. I wish all of you a lovely day, and goodbye!